Good evening and welcome to the Orchestra Winter Concert. We're so glad that you made it out here on this chilly night. And we're so glad that we decided to do this concert today instead of tomorrow night. Goodness gracious. We have a great show in store for you, and this is probably the last time you'll hear my voice for a little while. The students have prepared some remarks for each piece, and so they'll be delivering those. But thank you from the bottom of our hearts for being here tonight, and enjoy the show.
Is called Moonlighting. It's an interpretation of the piece Moonlight Sonata, written by Ludwig van Beethoven in the year 1801 in Vienna, Austria. The song starts out slow and melancholic before picking up into a lively tango. We hope that you enjoy this piece and the rest of our winter concert.
Just like the lights, the song could be perceived as such with its calming dynamics and its brightening and heightening peaks. With a fast pace, it makes you feel as if you are viewing the northern lights from Scandinavia. This phenomenal piece hits you with surprising highs and lows. Give a loud applause to a second song, Aurora Borealis.
Thank you. song is a Christmas classic. Well, three Christmas classics from A Charlie Brown Christmas. It was based off a comic strip called Peanuts that appeared in something, what was it called? A newspaper?
It includes songs like Linus and Lucy, Christmas Time is Here, and O Tannenbaum. When we saw this song for the first time, all the complex rhythms and harmonies. We can do it well now, but when we saw it, we shouted, "Good grief!"
Thank you. After hearing this piece, you think an Arlington is some sort of monster or demon. But our next piece, Arlington Sketches, was actually a commission for the orchestra from Arlington Heights, Illinois. This piece was composed by Elliot Del Borgo, who has formed an iconic style of music called Classical Del Borgo. This style contains a contrast of fierce and dim, a strong deep bass and high-pitched runs by violins. This is Arlington Sketches.
Thank you. Inspired by the late 80s and early 90s metal scene, San Francisco native Ted Allen found inspiration for a set of string metal pieces, including our opening piece, Fire in the Forge. Fire in the Forge has a rugged and driving cello and bass parts, keeping the whole piece afloat. Violins and violas build on top, with fleeting melodies and bold harmonies. Adapting the electric guitar sound to a string orchestra creates a unique take on metal that is both invigorating to play and listen to. As the piece reaches its climax, all instruments come together for an intense percussive ending.
To leave your cello right by an almost open door. You're gonna be really glad you took the time to do that. It's gonna sound so much better.
I play the viola.
And quick shout out to Melissa Schmidt's mom. It's her birthday today. The next song we're playing is going to be the Christmas song. The Christmas song came about from unexpected circumstances. According to one of the writers, Mel Torme, this song was written on a blistering hot day in July in an attempt to cool down. From just a few scrawled words on a journal page to a fully fledged song, this iconic holiday tune is wistful and sentimental to all those who hear. This song displays nostalgic and soft melodies throughout every instrument that reminds us of cozy, excited Christmas Eve nights. Please enjoy the Christmas song.
This piece is Inverno, which was arranged by Todd Parrish. It takes scenes from Vivaldi's Winter. This is what makes the piece so special. taking parts of a classic and adding modern elements to it. The word inferno means winter in Italian, which perfectly describes this piece. The melody of the song, which switches between each instrument, represents the feelings of winter, just like the feelings of tonight.
I really love the pieces we played tonight, but my favorite might just be our last one, Music from Frozen. Each instrument brings a beautiful harmony and contrast to this piece. I especially love the fact that each instrument gets an opportunity to play a melody, while the others add special touches to truly bring the magic of winter to the listener. In addition, the transitions between the three songs in this medley are done really beautifully. While you listen to our final piece, keep an ear out for our soloist, and try to guess which songs we play.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome. Tonight, Chamber Orchestra will be performing two songs. The first is Air on the G String by J.S. Bach. There are a few songs that resonate with feelings of anticipatory joy as much as this one. From the steady pizzicatos of the lower strings to the sweet tones of the violins that grow and dip with every passing measure, this unforgettable piece is likely to surprise and delight audiences for generations to come. Then, in true Champlain Park High School fashion, we are going to completely switch gears and play Dueling Jingle Strings by James Pierpoint, which is a holiday theme parody of Dueling Banjos, because nothing screams season's greetings quite like a fiddle war. I advise you to take cover, but keep your ears peeled for the back and forth rhythms and melodies in the upper and lower strings, and classic fiddle techniques such as kicking the rabbit, droning, and chopping. Now, please enjoy Air on the G String and Dueling Jingle Strings.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here. So, if you've ever seen some sort of event where people are performing acrobatics, for example, a circus, the Gymnastics Olympic event, a pink concert, then you probably have some sort of idea of what acrobatics is. When I say acrobatics, most people probably are thinking flips, flying through the air, trapeze, aerial silks, and the plummeting to the ground. Few reasons why I'm never going to attempt anything like that. And you'd be correct, that's exactly what acrobatics is. Now, since we're at an orchestra concert, you've probably deduced by now that something to do with acrobats is linked to our first piece, and you'd be correct. The title of our first piece is Acrobats. Now, the composer Richard Meier has somehow managed to transcribe an entire acrobatic routine onto a few sheets of sheet music. Sorry, Linnea. I'm not sure how he did it, but it sounds incredible. So the piece starts out with the upper strings playing three separate performers, flipping, jumping, tumbling towards the center of the stage. It then gets handed off to the cellos, who play the dramatic landing positions, and then transitions into a very smooth trapeze act. It then transitions to a very smooth trapeze act and finishes with a very dramatic landing pose. Now, as you listen to this lively piece, try to imagine some sort of thing like that, and you'll see how Richard Meier's musical decisions correspond to the illusion of an acrobatic performance.
Thank you. Our next piece is the Five Variants from Dives and Lazarus, composed by Ralph Vaughan Williams. The song is a traditional English folk ballad. You might recognize the tunes as it was used in the classic Irish folk tune Star of the County Down. Today we will be playing the introduction and theme and variants 3, 4, and 5. Dives and Lazarus tells the biblical story of the poor man Lazarus asking the rich man Dives for food and drink and being denied. When they both die, Lazarus is carried to heaven while Dives is dragged down to hell. In Hades, Dives asks Lazarus for a drop of water, but there is nothing Lazarus can do as Dives inflicted his internal punishment on himself. This piece has a harp part, and we are very excited for this to be played by harpist Evelyn Kirkham.
Thank you. As you know, the Nutcracker is a beloved holiday tradition and the cornerstone of classical music.
And tonight, our talented orchestra, accompanied by the winds, will be performing the two most iconic pieces from the ballet, the Trepak, also known as the Russian Dance, and the March of the Nutcracker. The lively, energetic rhythms of the Trepak fill the air as the orchestra expertly navigates the complex melodies and harmonies. The lively dance of the Russian peasants comes to life through the music, transporting us to a winter wonderland of sparkling snow and joyous celebration. But the excitement doesn't stop there. As the March of the Nutcracker begins, the orchestra swells with the grand majestic tones of Tchaikovsky's classical holiday score, the melodies swirl and dance, evoking the magic and wonder of the beloved ballet.
Thank you. Our final piece is a mashup of everything the holiday season encompasses. With beautiful melodies and smooth transitions between five beloved Christmas songs, this piece has everything you need to get you into the holiday spirit. Hopefully this piece brings you back to simpler times, being a child, sitting down in front of the TV on Christmas Eve, watching your favorite holiday movie, eagerly waiting for the return of Saint Nick the next day. But no matter if you celebrate Christmas or not, we ask that you sit back, relax, and enjoy our showing of Christmas at the Movies.
Thank you.
So much, and thank you. Can we give a big round of applause to Mikey, who's been doing our tech tonight? And for our custodial staff, who's just amazing, helping us out here tonight, and for all of you who make this possible, please give yourselves a hand as well. You give them some thunder there, okay. And finally, tonight, before you greet your loved ones, and this is also for those of you musicians who've already performed, if we could just really all work together on clearing the chairs. All these chairs, except for the winds we're sitting in, go to this orchestra room, so they all get in this right place, and stands as well. And thank you. Have a wonderful evening. Stay safe out there.